The 20th and 21st century have shown enormous gains in technology and techniques to provide, provoke, manipulate, and shape desire. Do we have an obligation to impose such technology on the public if we can use it to reduce self-destructive impulses? It's a heavy question.
Yeah, the if is the problem there. Mm. It's like, yes, if we could, we should, but we can't, so we shouldn't.
All right.
Because there's a conditional thing there. It's like, you can't actually answer that question in a sense, because you have to assume the premise. Part of what we've seen from the 20th century, and I think also, and this I do believe is part of what motivates the kind of approaches that have been discussed here today, is that the imposition of utopian plots does not produce utopia. Mm. In fact, it produces quite the opposite. And so I would say, don't ask questions like that. So, all right.
Do either of the other panelists have any thoughts to share on that one, or?
I want to understand the question a little bit better.
Sure.
The idea is we should manipulate people into becoming less self-destructive?
Yeah, so I mean, a lot of the ideas, I think, is talking about how the way marketing, public relations have kind of developed this whole psychological language to manipulate people. And so we can look at that as kind of an evil that works against free will, or should we look at it as kind of a tool that can be constructively used and should be constructively used?
Okay, so if you accept my framing, I have sort of a Socratic answer, not that I'm being pretentious and taking the role of Socrates, but he can't be here right now, so I'll try.
Fair and spirit.
I mean, here I want to invoke also Harry Frankfurt in some of his important work. I mean, Frankfurt wrote this really important essay. You'll please forgive me, but this is what it's called. It's called On Bullshit, right? And he's trying to distinguish between lying and bullshitting. And he says the difference between the liar and the bullshitter is the liar cares about the truth. And the liar, right, is counting on you caring about the truth in order to affect your behavior by lying. But the bullshitter is different. The bullshitter doesn't care about the truth. The bullshitter basically takes the salience landscape I've been talking about and severs it from tracking the truth, right? That all that matters is the catchiness of the idea, the infectious nature of the idea. So, you know, we're at the speech and the political America's great and we're all clapping. If America's so great, like, why do we need you, right? We all know that's not true, but we all, it's such a wonderful, you know, right? Or the marketer who, you know, here's the, you know, the anorexic supermodel on the yacht holding the beer, right? Right? Ah!
Light and, beer.
Well, the light beer, yeah, okay. Right? And you know that you're not gonna get her if you get that beer, and they know you know that, but that doesn't freaking matter, because that beer is now salient to you, and you'll buy the damn beer when you go in the store. Mm. Right? And so what happens is you start to pull salience from tracking reality in depth. You pull it away from the truth. And here's the Socratic worry. And this is why Socrates was worried about the sophists. He saw them doing that. He saw the sophists playing with relevance disconnected from the truth. And his worry was, you know, and maybe Jordan will disagree with me on this a bit, but we'll see. I mean, one of the things is it's hard to understand self-deception as lying to yourself, right? And this is sort of an idea, but you know what? You can bullshit yourself. You can sever how things, by paying attention in certain ways, you can sever how things are salient, how they're catchy to you. And you can get involved with that and rolling along with that, separate from the truth. So although you can't really lie to yourself, you can bullshit to yourself. And that, once you get into that, that self-deceptive strike, the cycle, like it starts rolling and rolling and rolling. And so I worry that we're gonna lose the ends in the means. We're gonna try and bring about a good society by basically, you know, habituating people more and more to bullshit and bullshitting each other and self-deceiving with increasing amounts of bullshit. So I don't think it's a good idea.
All right, very well put.
At least Socrates doesn't.